Good morning. How do we make it around to Wednesday again already? Time flies, doesn't it? Good morning, Ellen. How are you? Hi, Julie. Hi, Shelley. How is everyone today? Are you ready to paint? I had a bright and early morning. I usually get up. I've been trying to get up and walk in the mornings, but I didn't today because I have a lot to get ready still for my next lesson of Art in Bloom. So I didn't, but I actually did one of my little birds. I've been having so much fun painting these birds. Let me show you. Did a little female cardinal this morning. How cute, right? I love doing these little tiny paintings. And I've been working on my little Christmas ornaments. There's one of them, the little signature and the year on the back. So now I need to start putting all these together and doing photographs of them. It's kind of an overwhelming project, but a labor of love for sure. Good morning, Anita. Hi, Rosemary. Excuse me. I think I have like a little frog in my throat. And while I was doing that, I was playing with a new color. So we were talking yesterday, I did a landscape, which I love doing these. I've been itching to do a big one, but here's my little one from yesterday. And a lot of people suggested I do one this morning as my demo. So I'm going to try to do one of these like in the fun, excuse me, like fall colors, like brown and pink and with a little bit of cool blue. I had done this the other day. Like I love the colors in here. So who knows what'll happen. You know, it's always a little risky because I experiment sometimes or all the time. It's one of the fun things about art is being able to take risks and, you know, it's just art. You can throw it away if you don't love it. You guys won't judge me if I screw up, right? So let me turn this around and see where we go here. So I just have a sky up. It's not necessarily for, I don't want to be as literal about what I'm doing. Oh, thanks, Allie. Oh, let me show you. I did work on that a little bit last week. I had a little bit of time on Sunday morning, so I think it's making progress now. I love all the fun detail in it. I'm having a lot of fun, but, you know, I get afraid. Like it's, you know, sometimes it's a crazy thing when I work on a great big painting, I work on it and then I get fearful. So I just stop and let it sit for days or weeks and then I dive back in, which is a good way to get through the fear is you just ignore it until it goes away. I guess that's a method, right? So I think what I'm going to do is, I mean, I have to kind of move. It's gonna be a little funky because the canvas is different and it might be a little hard to work because you guys are literally right in front of me. I was gonna say, I was playing around with this color this morning too. It's called brown pink. It's very fun. So I'll show you that. So I'm going to like tone the canvas. I don't know if I wanna do, I think I wanna do pink underneath, a pink tone instead of, you know, mapping out the way I usually do with all the different colors. maybe pinks and browns. I don't know. We'll see. Got nothing to lose, so we're just gonna have fun. I like the idea of the pink underneath. I was going to work on an exercise with my Art in Bloom students this afternoon, and I have one of these toned in brown to start. I think this is, you know, more of a traditional way of starting a painting rather than mapping it out with transparency. Let me see, I might take a little bit more off of there. I do get little fibers on it from my paper towel. I try to clean them off as I go, but not a big deal. I'll probably take more off of there anyway. I'm going to close up my medium. I don't think I need it. If I have any trouble with keeping my things liquid, I'm going to use this liquid as my medium. All right, I'm cleaning my palette just a little bit. I have it too messy next to me, or I'll get myself in there. I'm going to do, oh no, I do need my medium. I put a little bit of like purple at my horizon line. I like having it be mostly clouds because mostly sky. Good morning, Audrey. So where's everybody from? You know, I love that question. I should tape this down, I guess, because it's going to keep scooching around. I'm not sure what I want to do here. You know, I think I'm going to. This is uncharted territory, so I'm going to do some of my pigment sticks because I feel like it. It's fun just listening to your intuition and not having the pressure of needing anything to become anything right away. Well, that's a bit of a departure from what I'm aiming for, but that's okay. I need a little bit of that in the sky, too. What did I do with it? My little stub. Lake Tahoe. Oh, how wonderful. Alabama, Ontario, Canada, Texas, Ireland. Hello to Ireland. Western North Carolina and Appalachians. But that's beautiful there, right, this time of year. Caroline. I have a friend in Asheville, or Brevard, actually. I was there to visit not too long ago. And it's so pretty. Well, I guess it was a long time ago now. Time's flying. Two Rivers, Wisconsin. Rain. Is it rainy in Florida? I didn't even know it rained in Florida. I just feel like it's always warm and sunny there. Well, this looks crazy, doesn't it? All right. I'm going to let it be wild and crazy. UK, Pennsylvania, yes. Good old Pennsylvania. At least it's not cold here yet. About that, I am happy. It was beautiful weather yesterday. Well, that's a reckless, crazy start, right? Lancaster, Ellen. Good old Lancaster. Ellen only lives a few minutes from me. Okay. Cleaning off my palette. So I want to mix some browns. Lumpy thing there. I always have to clean them off. I think I'm gonna use my thanks, Lonnie. Good morning, Em. I'm gonna maybe just pull some of the color away. Shaking the thing too much. Just started watching. Oh man, what you got done in 9 minutes. Can you just chat about what you've done so far quickly? Yes, I'm really just playing. I did a landscape yesterday and I decided I would love to play with doing one in like kind of fall browns and pinks.
And that's not at all what this looks like now. And it could be not at all what it turns out as. But I just did a pink ground background, and it's permanent rose. And kind of just wipe some of it away. And I'm really just playing. Totally recklessly playing. Yeah, I've been, I do things too fast sometimes. I could get a lot done in 9 minutes. Okay. Yeah, I already did my little bird this morning. I did this little guy this morning. So, girl. This is a girl, not a guy. What should her name be? So I'm getting a bunch of them ready to go to Red Raven Art Gallery in Lancaster. Okay, so I want to mix some browns. Browns are not my comfort zone. I never used to like the color brown, and now I'm learning to appreciate it. I'm going to mix this, some of this liquid and put it out too. So I'm going to mix some blues and browns. So I'm going to use my blues as my cools. All right. So yes, I'm totally experimenting. I have no idea what I'm doing here. No, I think that's too brown. Too brown, too brown. Should I have the underneath part of my clouds be brown? I just am not totally sure what I'm doing. But... I have been, you know, itching to change something up with my something. I don't know. I didn't know if it was with my practice or with my subject matter or what it was, but maybe it's my color palette. You know, when you get that feeling like you want to change something and you're not sure what it is, you just have to play with different things until something happens kind of organically. I don't know if I'm going to like a brown sky. Not sure what I think about that. Yesterday it sounded fun. Like some pops of vibrant, isn't that? That's such a beautiful color. And look at that next to the brown. Mix a little bit of this in there. Make it a little more neutral. I'm telling you, I could just sit here and mix pink colors all day long. Oops. These little brushes out because I was doing the cardinal. They're pretty colors, aren't they? I might just not be a brown person. You're right. I don't know. Yeah, maybe. But I also think, that the more I learn, like that's my next thing. Like I love bright colors, but now I need to find more ways of working with my art and doing... I think I'm going to just start with that. See where we go. What are the colors? Oh, in the pink. They are permanent rose and transparent magenta, I think is what that color. Oh, no, it's this one that I love. It's this Vasari rosebud. I think I need more of that. But you can use the Gamblin radiant magenta is the other color that you could use instead. It's less expensive. good. Can you guys see? I need a sip of my coffee. And I have to remember that I don't need to hurry. Something I do. Oh, I was trying to blend yesterday too, like use a blending brush. I'm not sure if I like blending or if I like it to be not blended. But I think I might have one here. I could play around with that. I want to tape this down. Hi, Amy. There, that's good. That's good. So what's new with everybody? Anything new? Anything fun going on? Watching any fun TV shows? I don't watch TV very often, but I did start watching a show with my friend last week called Emily in Paris. It's a Netflix, very cute. I'm enjoying it. And trying to think what else is new with me. My daughter, her cross-country team runs in leagues today, this afternoon. She usually helps me when I do my live for my Art in Bloom course, but she's going to have to leave early, so I'm going to have to wing it a little bit because she has her league meet. And the boys' team from the same school, they they won the whole meet yesterday. So because of COVID, they're distancing and parents aren't allowed to come to the meet, which stinks. We've watched our kids run. All of our children were on the cross country team, so this is the first year we can't go watch. I'm trying to think if I need more blue in my sky. I don't know. Do a little blue here. I like how I don't know if you can see it, because of the texture from the pigment sticks is really pretty. I want to try and keep some of that. The gold, it's kind of translucent or a little glimmery. Love a little glimmery. Oh, you watched Emily in Paris? Did you watch the whole thing? Does it go quick? I watched it. It was a good show to get away from. Yes, that's what I love about it. I love the browns and pinks with, yep. Love it too, Audrey. Yeah, not to go watch. It is. It's crazy. It is crazy. Life is crazy right now. Like, I want to be able to see my brush strokes. I don't want to get in my own way and start judging this. That's the fun thing about doing a landscape like this. It doesn't need to be anything because it's whatever it turns into. I love a good pink sky. Do I need more? I kind of like that pause there. Yeah, I don't know if Emily in Paris has more than one season. I didn't look ahead, but I kind of hope it lasts a while. My friend and I usually on Sundays, I don't watch TV like hardly ever, but it is nice sometimes to sit down and do that. To not think and not feel like I need to be learning something or doing something. Because I'm usually learning or doing. I'm not usually doing nothing. No fun over here. Writing an essay. What are you writing an essay for? I wish I liked to write, Megan. I don't like writing. Fun colors, right? Just one season. Okay. Fun to see that. Yes. Wouldn't it be neat to go there? Who taught you about big brush strokes? I don't know. I think it's always been a goal of mine. I'm not sure. I'm trying to think who taught me about big brush strokes. You know, I watch so many other artists. Like, whenever I have free time, that's something I do, is try to learn. Like, right now, I accidentally kind of, one morning I woke up and I had an ad for a David LaFell. Do you know who that is? Bright Light Studios. And when I first started painting, I subscribed to their channel or whatever it was and really loved it. And they were offering a little mini course. And he is so charming and so brilliant. But it's like one lesson comes out every day for like 10 days. And they're like three or four hours long. And he might just be lecturing or painting. I absolutely love it. But like, it's a huge time commitment because you only have it for 90 days. And I know if I let too much time pass, we're going to get near Christmas and I won't watch it. But I love learning that kind of stuff. But I don't think I love just how he puts paint on the canvas. Like, it's just beautiful to watch him paint, and his paintings are gorgeous. So if you don't know who that is, check him out. David LaFell, yeah. I think it's two Fs. Last year of my degree, and it's about motivation in second language learning. Wow. Well, that sounds very interesting. Good for you. I hope you do well on your paper. And so my daughter's been writing her essay for college. It's a crazy year to be doing that. I don't know. Is it too messy looking? Painting sunflowers in watercolor. Oh, Sheila, that sounds like fun. Oh, LaFell is, I think, LeFFel. That sounds like lots of fun. Yeah, I did my little watercolor with those Prestigify paints that I got. It was fun. Might be too pink and not brown enough. What do you think? A little reckless and just put some stuff in here and not... I'm fussing over the little details. So I'm always telling everybody else not to do that, and that's what I'm doing. If I don't like it, I can wipe it away, right? I think I need a little more blue. You love the pink. Okay, Julie, here I am wiping it out. I think I need a blendy thing. And it is good to do things like this. Like, this is totally not my comfort zone. It's not how I paint. But it makes you grow when you try things that aren't so comfortable. Because you figure out how to solve problems and think things through differently than you would otherwise. Always learning. And that's the fun thing about art, is there's always something new to learn, to explore, to get better at. That blue in there is really pretty, isn't it? Looks like a wild sky. Let's see if I have one of those blendy brushes I never do. Let's see what it does if I play with that one of these. These are hard to clean, but getting a little browner, but I want those pops of pink to stay. Something in my paint there. Get that out. A little lumpy thing. Still right there on the side. Kind of fun. Oh, my favorite artist. Someone just asked me that yesterday. It was a really hard question. So many favorites, like dozens. I don't know. And I can't even think of the name of the one who's coming to mind visually. Oh, thank you. Blending that. Yeah, it's kind of fun blendy like that, isn't it? Okay, so what do I want to do? Some maybe lighter blue. All the colors are really fun. I think I need lighter blue. In the details. Greens are beautiful in the foreground. Thank you, Sheila. Yeah, I kind of like that part. I don't even know if I need to touch that more. I'm not sure what I need to do, though. I'm not sure if I need to blend more. Maybe the underneath part. I definitely need my lightest lights. That's the part I didn't do yet. I always do that at the very end. I could carve into these a little bit. Picking up some of the color from down here and pulling it up. Because colors from clouds always reflect onto the ground, or is it the other way around? I don't know. Might be the other way around. Kind of got rid of most of those strokes that I did with the blending thing. It looks a little, even a little opalescent. Is that the right word? I signed on late. Are you painting? Oh, I am, but it's not really. It's overhearing me. It's just, it's not really, I'm not really, I'm only looking at it to see like what part of the clouds have light on them. Like, it's just like my comfort zone. I'm not really painting from it. I like kind of mixing doing the landscape with kind of intuitive painting. It does feel good to do that sometimes, to not be trying to make anything look like anything. You know what I mean? Like, I'm always trying so hard. Can I ask, in your class, the arch, or do you cut or rip? Oh, the arches, I cut it, but if you can figure out how to rip it, that's on my list of things that I'd like to do, is figure out how to wet it just enough to get a nice rip. Like, I don't want it rip sloppy. I would love it, like, to look almost like the deckled edge, but the way that a piece of paper has the deckled edge like this is because it's, like, thinner there. When they make the paper, like, I've gotten to go to paper mills, like, that's the edge of the paper. So I would love it if I could get that edge on all the sides, but I cut it. At my office, I have a cutting board, and that's where I cut. Like, I need to cut out these, all my little ornaments I do in a little, like a little film strip. So I need to go cut these out. It's fun. I love cutting things out. It kind of, what beach spot? Oh, it's Rehoboth Beach, Delaware. That's where I've been going to the beach as long as I can remember. And I always get lucky that there's usually beautiful clouds when we're there. I love to go more often. Try holding a ruler down and rip along the edge. I should try that. I'm always hesitant to, because the paper's so expensive. I don't want to mess it up. But I guess it really wouldn't mess that much. I could just do a little piece, because I was going to take it and cut some out today. I've used up all my little pieces. And I love the texture of it. Clouds are one of those things I love about. Yes, we do have beautiful clouds. Whoops. Absolutely. When I go for my walks, I often have to stop and take photos because the clouds are so pretty. There. Oh, you're welcome. You guys can ask me anything. I'll do my best to answer. I don't know all the answers, but I'm going to do my best. Starting to come together. I should master landscapes and do that as my next online course. Wouldn't that be fun? Be fun for me. Which color brand are you using and size of paper? This is Arches oil paper. And I get the great big ones. I don't know what size they are, and just cut them down. Because I keep thinking I'm going to do a great big painting on it. I haven't done that. But I also got some other cool paper. I don't know where it is. It's like, it's canvas, but it's on a tablet. I have to look for that. I forgot I had it. I do that a lot. I buy my art supplies and never remember to use them. You guys ever do that? You get so excited when it comes, and then there's never time to, like, dive into it. And then I end up putting it away and forgetting I have it. The blending is very relaxing. I love these colors in here. Frame this behind glass. No, I don't think I would. I think I would varnish it and frame it without glass. Maybe show a little bit of the messy edge, depending how it looks when I take the tape off. I love when the edges like that. I like that it's not perfect. I like perfectly imperfect paper paintings. I would just frame them. I would put varnish on it and frame it because it is oil paint. So you don't want to put oil paint under glass because I think it cures and dries for like ever. What else do you think it needs? Is this purple too bright? I don't think so. I'm loving the colors. Really pretty. All right, I'm thinking about, do I need anything else? Oh no, let me show it to you closer. I'm not sure if I'm finished or not. Here, let me show you. Try and get the light. Like, I love those colors in there. I love all the colors, actually. It is very fun. Very different from the colors in the one that I did yesterday. Can you see them? A whole different palette. And these clouds are puffy. I kind of like these individual ones. Are they too equally sized? Whoops, I got this in my... always have too much going on here in my studio to stay tidy. Leave acrylic meaning on paper. Oh, acrylic I put under glass. Oils I do not. Because acrylics dry so quickly. You can put them under glass like really soon. That is the charm of painting with acrylics, is when you're done, you can just be finished and move on. And I might do a little lighter lights. You think I need? No, I don't know if I do. It's like meditation. It is for me too. Do you price the paper the same as the gesso board paintings? Ellen, I don't know. Yeah, I do. I've only sold a few. I don't even usually list them for sale, but like one of the ones that I did in my calendar that I did for this year, someone in Sweden, I think, bought it. My gosh, paintings take forever to get there. And it was the same because it takes... It's the same piece of art. It's just not on a board. So yeah, I say yes. Yeah. I was just busy setting up ship station yesterday because I need for the holidays. I would like to simplify shipping. So that's been a whole thing that I've been kind of avoiding forever. So I started working on that yesterday, which makes me feel good. Sometimes it's good to get those things out of the way that seem overwhelming. And when you do them, they're not so bad. You're welcome, Ellen. Yeah, maybe I just need some more definition of the ones that are closer. Is it getting better or neutral? What do you think? I think I might need to be finished. So, I'm going to sign it. And then I'm going to pull the tape off. I don't know. I love this. Ever since college, when I used to do pencil drawings and I'd tape off the edges, pulling off the tape at the end is always sort of just fun. Can't get it off. I just put that on there this morning. And you have to be careful because you don't want to pull up your any of the paper. And I love where it bleeds under like that. That's totally fine. So there it is. Can you see? Too bright. I'm trying to get it so you can see it better. Oh, that's a good view, right? So how fun. Right? So, yeah, and that's what I looked at. It's totally not that, but fun practice, fun to do. Oh, yes, let me turn it around. So you can let me know if you have any questions. Yes, I use this same brush that I love. It's the Rosemary & Company Eclipse Short Flat number 12. I use it even when I paint this tiny thing, and look how big it is. It's like, it's literally, this is 4 inches, this is probably 1 inch. And except for the eyes. When I do the eyes, I use a tiny brush. Love painting eyes and birds. I need to try painting some people eyes, and it'd be fun. So thanks for coming, guys. It was good to see all of you. Some of you I'll see this afternoon at 1 o'clock when I do my Facebook Live for my Art in Bloom group. Now, which brand? I use all different brands. Winsor & Newton is an easy go-to. I use a lot of Gamblin. And on the more expensive side, I love Azari. And I love Old Holland paints. So I've experimented over time, and I have tons of favorites. How do you keep your painting so loose? Just practice. It's been my goal. I can paint tight. I could paint something very tight, very exact, but I wanted to loosen up my style, and always a journey. I did put gesso down first. Yes, Rosemary, I did this gesso underneath. When you say the gallery starts sales, oh, it's on Black Friday. They do it on Black Friday. Usually they have a line around the block. I don't know how they're going to do it this year because they're not going to be able to let people in. I don't know if they're going to do it online or if they'll just let a few people in at a time. I would love to collect them. So a lot of people collect all the little ones each year. They buy one and then fill a whole wall with them. I want to do that too. And I'll have a few on my website too. But just a few. So anyway, guys, thanks for coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day. I will save this and put it on my YouTube channel. And if you go to my YouTube channel, be sure to subscribe. And leave me a comment. Like, whenever you comment on anything, like, it helps with algorithms or whatever. Like, it's love whenever you comment or ask me questions. You're always welcome to. Okay, I'll keep you posted on the sale. I'll post about it on my website and on social. Bye, Allie. So, see you guys. I hope you have a wonderful day. We'll see you next week. Bye.